Just because no one else can heal or do your inner work for you doesn't mean you can, should, or need to do it alone. Be confused. It's where you begin to learn new things. Be broken. It's where you begin to heal. Be frustrated. It's where you start to make more authentic decisions. Be sad. Because if we are brave enough, we can hear our heart's wisdom through it. Be whatever you are right now. No more hiding. You are worthy, always. Well, on this World Mental Health Day, I, Sanchali Arora, welcome you all to yet another exciting episode of Wellness 360 from Home with ICICI Lombard, where we know that during these tough times, the most critical thing for all of us is nobody but us. Our most fruitful investment is our own well-being. Well, as WHO says, this year's World Mental Health Day comes at a time when our daily lives have changed considerably as a result of COVID-19 pandemic. The past months have brought many challenges for healthcare workers providing care in difficult circumstances, going to work fearful of bringing COVID-19 home with them. For students, adapting to taking classes from home with little contact with teachers and friends, and anxious about their futures. For workers whose livelihoods are threatened, for the vast number of people caught in poverty or in fragile humanitarian settings with extremely limited protection from COVID-19. And for people with mental health conditions, many experiencing even greater social isolation than before. And this is to say that nothing of managing the grief of losing a loved one, sometimes without being able to say goodbye. Well, friends, ladies and gentlemen, being mentally healthy doesn't just mean that you don't have a mental health problem. If you're in good mental health, you can, of course, do a number of things. Make the most of your potential, cope with life, play a full part in your family, workplace, community, and of course, among friends. Well, some people call mental health emotional health or well-being, and it's just as important as, I think, good physical health. Mental health is everyone's business. We all have times when we feel down or stressed or maybe frightened. Most of the time, those feelings pass. But sometimes they develop into a more serious problem, and that could happen to any one of us. Everyone is different. You may bounce back from a setback while someone else may feel weighed down by it for a very long time. Your mental health doesn't always stay the same. It can change as the circumstances change and you move through different stages of course, your life. Well, friends, there is a stigma attached to mental health problems. This means, of course, that people feel uncomfortable about them and don't talk about them much, right? Many people don't even feel comfortable talking about their feelings, forget about anything else. But as they say, it's healthy to know and to say what you're feeling inside. Now, to tread this journey of happiness together and in an endeavor to keep us all healthy, ICICI Lombard today brings to you an extremely special and renowned guest, Dr. Anjali Chhabria, a leading psychiatrist, psychotherapist, and now an author of Death is Not the Answer, Understanding Suicide and Ways to Prevent It, has always been contributing to the field of mental health since 27 years. She runs Mind Temple, Mumbai, a mental health center which supports the psychiatric, emotional, and of course, behavioral needs of individuals by using a combination of different techniques and viewpoints, which of course is facilitated by the psychiatrists and psychologists who work together tailoring the treatment process. Now, with the increasing need to reach out to the corporates, she has launched the Mind Temple Institute of Behavior Sciences. She's a trained past life regression therapist, hypnotist, and introduced innovative treatment modalities with the aim of constantly improving patient care. She's also the founder of Golden Citizens Trust, which was statutorily established in 2018. She has been the president of the Bombay Psychiatric Society in 2001, served on the board of the Children's Film Society, and is currently a director on the Salaam Bombay Foundation. Well, she's here with us, and I'm more than elated to get her here on board for all of you. Thank you very much, ma'am, for joining us here, and a very, very warm welcome to you.
Thank you, Sanchali, for this beautiful introduction. Happy Mental Health Day to everybody over here. I'm so thankful to ICICI Lombard for doing these wellness sessions, you know, because I understand it has helped so many people. You know, they're trying to cover all the subjects. And I'm so glad that today mental health is being given as much importance as physical health. And true to their word of wellness, you know, wellness is something that we all look at. And of course, just imagine today, if you don't feel well in your mind, you could be sitting in the best of places, you could be eating the best of food, but at the same time, do you feel good? Of course not, because it's just like a computer. You know, today, if your center is not working properly, if your mind is not working properly, you don't feel good. So wellness begins and starts from mental health. Mentally, if you feel fit, you feel physically fit, whether it is COVID, whether it is non-COVID. Now, of course, today what we are talking about is wellness has, mental wellness has never been as important as it is today. The last 6 months have taught us so much, you know. So what have you learned, Sanjali, in the last 6 months?
Well, the last 6 months taught me, as we were talking, ma'am, to learn how to do this thing virtually. That's the first thing I learned. And of course, realize that, you know, it is okay not to be okay and to feel each and every feeling and go through it and probably seek help if I need to and not struggle all alone.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So to all the viewers today, you know, I know we've gone through a lot in the last 6 months. And but the last 6 months has taught us something which is very important, and that is to take care of our physical health. You know, I feel so happy whenever I go somewhere and someone checks my temperature. I said, the entire country is so worried about my health, you know. So everywhere you go, people are checking your temperature, giving you sanitizers because they want to make sure that you're physically healthy, ensuring that you're wearing your mask properly. I feel the next 1 year has to be talking about our mental health, our mental well-being. Because if you are fit here, you're able to do whatever you want, you know. And just to, you were talking about the WHO, just to tell you that, you know, even before COVID started, WHO's findings were that 1 out of 7 people in India are suffering from a mental health condition. You know, so that means if you're looking at your extended family of, say, 20, 21 people, there are 3 people who are not well, you know. But what happens is, as you spoke about the stigma is so high, you know, ki, oh my God, aap psychiatrist ke paas jayenge, psychiatrist ke paas to sirf pagal log jaate hain. And the stigma was so high earlier also when I wanted to take up psychiatry, that there were doctors who came to my house when they came to know that, yes, I'm going to become a psychiatrist. They came and sympathized with my parents. They said, ki are humne socha hai ki psychiatrist khud 20 saal ke baad patient kaun hai, psychiatrist kaun hai, pata hi nahi chalta hai. Okay, so here I am in front of you. And today these are the same people who will come and say, ki I'm so glad you took up this field because there is so much happening around us. So coming back to this, that in every family, there are people who are suffering from depression, who are suffering from anxiety, who are suffering from maybe OCD, from either, you know, physical health issues, which are related to the mind. Okay, addictions have become such a big problem today. So what we need to do is look around to these people, look around for them and help them to feel better about themselves and to help them to get help. Now, how do we go about it? You know, so the first thing is, together, I'm thankful that we are talking about mental health so that we are already eradicating the stigma. Okay, now what typically happens in a family today, if we are looking at post-COVID, okay, there is a family of maybe 6 to 7 people in our house where the parents are not only trying to work from home, but they're also trying to take care of their kids. The kids are fed up of looking at the screen. you know, I know there are a lot of parents over here who complain that our kids want more screen time. But the children have to wake up in the morning, whether they get ready or whether they're only wearing a shirt on top or they're lying down and they're watching their online school. They are getting a little tired because they want to go out and play. They want to meet their friends. They want to go to school because school is also about socializing. So because of that, they're getting really irritable. Now, managing an irritable child is a huge task, okay, for parents itself. The parents are trying to do their work from home. Work itself has become difficult. Economic crisis has hit almost everybody. So that means that you have to do your best. You have to be able to show that, yes, your job is secure and you're also making some money. Now, that is what is happening to the parents. If you look at the woman of the house, you know, whether it's a working woman or a housewife, okay, the working woman has a lot of stress because, you know, suddenly everybody sees her around the house. And when you see your mother around in the house, you want her to make you breakfast. You want her to give you everything in your hand, you know. And especially if the working woman is living with her in-laws, she also feels extremely responsible. Ki chalo, if I'm at home, I should make rotis and give it to them because otherwise I don't. So there's a lot of stress on her because for her, the day never ends. It's just a 24/7 routine which is going on and on. Waking up in the morning, making sure kids are studying, taking care of everybody's health, making sure that, you know, now people don't have staff in the house. So the housework has to be done as well. You know, I also know that a lot of families have come together in this time of crisis. You know, children are doing so many household chores and, you know, parents are getting together and doing the work. But a little bit, I think people are also getting fed up of it. You know, so if you go out, it will look ki COVID kaha hai, COVID to hai hi nahi, you know, because people have just reached this stage where they feel that we just want to get out. Of course, the elders in the house are also suffering because somewhere they feel ki whether we'll ever be able to get out or we'll not be able to get out because, you know, it's almost coming to the end of the year and they have been locked up at home. Some of them are so much in fear because they have got these stories in their head ki humme COVID ho jayega. Somebody will come, pick us up and put us in a hospital and that's the last time we will be in the house. You know, some families are very lax. They're just walking around without masks, coming in, not having a shower. And then there are those paranoid families. And in all this, what is suffering is everybody's mental health. Now, how do we take care of our mental health? You know, so just as we have dental hygiene where we get up in the morning and we brush our teeth, the same way there is also something which is called as mental hygiene or emotional hygiene, which is what we talk about, you know. Now, some of the tips for that is that the first thing is being in contact with your mind, knowing what is happening to you. Okay, so understanding your emotions, understanding your feelings. Unfortunately, people don't talk about emotions. You know, so if I ask everyone today, okay, name 5 emotions, you'll be able to name 5 emotions. But if I tell you to name 10 emotions, I see people start struggling. Because what happens is no one has taught us to identify our emotions. In fact, when you're small and if you're crying, the first thing you hear is stop crying and do your work. And that is something which I want all the viewers to stop doing today. Especially those living with little kids, please teach them to learn about their emotions. Now, sometimes parents also get a little anxious. They feel, oh, if we talk about emotions, our children are going to become so emotional that they are not going to be, you know, that they'll wallow in self-pity. Fortunately, that does not happen. When you start understanding anything, that is the first step towards making things better, towards also being able to take charge of our emotions. So what do I mean? The next time your child is crying, instead of telling him, stop crying, if you tell him, sorry, if you tell him that finish crying and tell me what you were crying about. Now, what is the message you've given to the child is that it's all right to cry. It's all right to have an emotion like sadness. It's all right to feel feared. Okay. And then once they are more in control, you can talk to them and ask them what makes them cry, what makes them fearful, and help them to go to the next step. And that is emotional resilience. The world today is talking about emotional resilience. What does it mean? It means that today, if you're emotionally resilient, you know, just if you're physically resilient, if your physical immunity is high, even if you get COVID, you'll be able to get out of it with little damage. Similarly, today, if you're emotionally resilient, you will be able to deal with situations in life that may not, I mean, that may go out of control. Just like these 6 months have taught us. I have EMIs to pay and suddenly income has stopped, you know, or suddenly business has stopped. The richest of people today are struggling financially, you know, and so on. So to become emotionally resilient means that our adjustment quotient is high. What is adjustment quotient? Adjustment quotient is that when we are going through a situation where things are not going according to the way we want to, we are able to adjust, we are able to adapt. The more adaptable we are, the more adjusting we are, the more we'll be able to go forward. How do you do that? You do that by being in touch with your emotions, by understanding that, yes, I can feel anxious. You know, anxiety is that feeling of ghabrahat that we get. It's that feeling, you know, where your stomach is churning, your hands are shaking, your mouth is going dry, just as we feel when we are going for an exam. You know, when that feeling starts happening to you again and again, one thing which I tell anyone and everyone who comes to me is go down to that feeling, go down and ask yourself, what is making me anxious? Okay, so either it will be that, oh my God, I've got fever. Do I have COVID? Okay, now that's a real anxiety. What can you do about it? The first thing you can do about it is not ignore the symptoms and get a test done. You know, just this morning I was talking to someone who was saying, oh, but it's only 99 fever. I said, that's when you get it checked because you don't want to land up with the complications of COVID. At such a time, if we remind ourselves that yes, there are a lot of people who are getting this problem, but only 0.5% of them, I mean, 70% are sailing through COVID with mild symptoms. 20% go into mild to moderate category, and it is only the 5 to 10% that land up in hospital. And it is only 3% of the entire figure that can really have too many complications or lose their life. So what can we do when we feel anxious is go down to your anxiety and find out what is making you anxious. I've been dealing with a lot of people who are just anxious because of the fear that what will happen to me if I get COVID. Okay. Now to such people, if you have taken, if you've done whatever you could do, that means you're bandaging, you're sanitizing yourself, you're washing your hand, you're wearing your mask, you're keeping social distance. You're doing whatever you can. अभी अगर इसके बाद भी अगर आप बीमार हो जाओगे दैट यू मे गेट कोविड देन इट इज नॉट फॉर यू टू वरी इट इज फॉर योर फैमिली मेंबर्स टू कॉन्टैक्ट द डॉक्टर इट्स फॉर द डॉक्टर टू टेक केयर ऑफ यू सो सिमिलरली वट एवर मेक्स अस एंग्शियस सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू नो आई नो अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल आर स्ट्रगलिंग विद फाइनेंसिस दीज डेज सो दिस इज समथिंग दैट आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर इज दैट सो वट कैन वी डू अबाउट इट सो वन इज दैट लुक एट आर एंटायर फाइनेंशियल सिचुएशन Okay, make an assessment of what is our expenditure and to what is our earning. Is there something that I do not need in this? Okay, can I bring my finances down? You know, if I can do that, do I really need that car? Do I really need that bike? You know, do I really need that gold that I had saved for a rainy day? Today is a rainy day. What are the basic essentials? Should I? And the second thing that I would tell everybody here today is please share your emotions. share your stress. Do not think, oh my God, if I tell my wife how stressed I am about money, she will get very stressed. If I tell my children that we are going through financial difficulties, they are going to get worried. This is the time to share. If you cannot share with your family, pick up the phone and share with your childhood buddy. You know, just talk to him and say that, you know, mujhe bahut stress ho raha hai. I'm not able to manage my finances. Share it with your siblings. Share it with your children. Share it with your parents. When we share, there are two things that will happen. First of all, that shame that we feel that, oh my God, you know, I'm a failure. How have I landed up in my situation? That goes away. Because when you have shared your problems with them, what can happen is your friend or your family member will, one is, hear you out. Okay. When they hear you out, your mind becomes calmer and you will be able to absorb what they are telling you. Chances are that your friend will tell you that, you know, I'm also going through this, the same thing, but I decided to, you know, either sell off something that I did not need or to take a loan from this place. Second thing that will happen is your friend will also share with you and you will make deeper connections, deeper bonds will happen. Okay. And then once you'll have finished sharing your negative stories, you'll actually feel more relaxed and you'll be able to talk to your friend about, you know, something maybe you all did in childhood. You'll be able to laugh about it. COVID has definitely taught us to make deeper connections. You know, I don't like this word social distancing, because actually what we have done in the last 6 months is only keep a physical distance. Socially, we've all been more connected. You know, at the beginning of lockdown, there was something that I was telling everybody, and this is something that is true even today. You know, divide your day into five. For everybody who's listening here today, is divide your day into five. One part of it, take care of your health. Okay. So whether it is eating properly, whether it is exercising, whether it is sleeping well, okay, do that. 30 to 40% of people developed a lot of sleep problems when the COVID happened, because what was happening is that people were sleeping on the bed, people were eating on the bed, people were working on the bed. So the brain started getting mixed signals because they thought ki bed is office space, bed is dining room. Okay. So the first thing that I tell everybody, that if you are one of those people, please get out of bed. Even if you stay in a small accommodation where you only have a room, sit on the ground and work. The second thing is, as soon as you wake up in the morning, okay, within the first 20 minutes, I don't want you to lie down in bed and keep thinking about all the problems, because the more you do that, the more emotionally down you will get. Okay, everybody is struggling with some or the other issues. So get out of bed in the first 15, 20 minutes and go and get something for you to eat or drink and do it yourself. Don't wait for other people to do it. Don't say, oh, my wife hasn't got woken up. When she wakes up, she'll make coffee for me. No, get up, go make your own coffee or tea and make it for her as well. Okay, when you do that, the third thing you do is sit somewhere where you're getting enough sunlight. Sunlight, besides giving you vitamin D, and vitamin D is fantastic. It helps you to combat. I mean, it helps you to get some strength in your body. So even if you get COVID, you'll be able to deal with it better. Okay. Besides that, it gives you the feeling, yes, today is a new day. Okay. And then the next thing one has to do in whatever capacity you can do is some exercise. Some people like to walk, some people like to run, some people like to do yoga, whatever you like to do. Okay. Dancing is fantastic. All you need is one area and some music, you know, and just put some headphones and start dancing. You know, automatically when you start moving your body, you feel good, you feel better. Okay. Watch what you eat. Okay. And do not undereat or do not overeat. You know, sometimes we start emotionally overeating and that itself can create a lot of stress, because then you see your body going out of shape, you feel your mind is going out of shape. So it's important that we do this. So when you're looking after your body, okay, eating your vitamins, and don't overdo it. You know, when whole day if I'm exercising or whole day if I'm eating vitamins and having kadas and all that, whole day I'm actually focusing on negativity. Okay, so only 1/5 of your day. The next 1/5 is about your work, whatever your work is. So even if you're, I mean, if you're a housewife, you have a lot of work to do in the house. Okay, but you should only spend 1/5 of your time doing it. Okay. And some people may turn around and tell me, oh, how can you say this? You know, there's so much work in my house, it never ends. See, there are other people in the house itself. Get them to get involved with the housework. Give them responsibilities. You know, I've heard a lot that, nahi, main bolti hoon, magar koi kaam nahi karta hai. It's okay, get them to do it. Find innovative ways to get your children to work, to get other people to work in the house. When we divide the house duties, people also feel more involved in the house and the house becomes their own. If you're an office worker, you know, remember 1/5 of your time, 1/5 is for taking care of yourself, 1/5 is for your work. Manage your work in such a way that whatever emails you need to do, keep your social media off. We do not need to know any more details about what happened to the celebrity, whether he died of murder or whether it was suicide. It is not. We don't need to know that. We don't need to know the scores of COVID every day. Okay, it is not helping us. So keep, and we don't need to read every WhatsApp that comes to us. We don't need to respond to every group that we are a part of. So keep your social media off and do your work in such a way that you have divided your day into your work timings, wherever, whatever you need to do, you have completed it. The third 1/5 is about other things that you want to do, whether it is learning a new skill, whether it is studying, whether it is music, whether it is dance, do that. Because when the mind is learning something, see, what has happened is that because a lot of people are working out of home, they tend to slag, you know, and the mind becomes a little slow, mind becomes a little dull, we get irritable. You know, a lot of senior citizens I have seen have become forgetful because we don't know what is the day, what is the date. And in doing all these things, you know, the mind is not learning any new skill. So whether it is a child, whether it is an adult, whether it is a senior citizen, we all need to keep upgrading our skills. And when you upgrade a skill, you know, I mean, the last 6 months have shown us so many different things that, you know, I've realized one thing is that every second person is such a fantastic cook and people have discovered all these skills about themselves, you know, and of course, they're also making money out of. So if you have a skill that you've always wanted to, you know, check that, okay, am I good at this? This is the time to do it. You know, you don't know what will happen, you know, whether, you know, there's something that we've always learned that when you love what you're doing and you do what you love, you know, time just goes by and you don't get stressed. So that is the third thing you do. The fourth thing is making deep connections with people around you. You know, I know that a lot of us don't have time for that. But when I'm talking about deep connections, you don't need more than 5 minutes a day to make a deep connection with whoever you want to. So whether it is your employee, whether it is your employer, whether it is your aunt, whether it is your relative, whether it is your child, whether it is your parent, you know, it's important that we make those deep connections with them. We just check on them, ask them how they are doing. And when we ask them how they are doing, they will automatically ask us how we are doing. And that is good for our emotional health because, yes, we start sharing, we start learning how to share, you know. And when we start sharing our own emotions, okay, it helps us to feel at ease. The fifth very, very important thing that I want you to do is give back in any which way. Give back to, it can be to plants, to trees, to animals, to people around you. You know, get involved with some cause that you can. Okay, now again, it has always been seen that for your own emotional health, when you start doing that, you feel much better. Now, the next thing I want to talk to you about is what are emotional disorders? What are mental health disorders? You know, at the beginning of the talk, I told you about, you know, 1 in 7 people are suffering from a mental health condition. Now, what do I mean by that? Just as anybody can get COVID, whether you're old, young, child, parent, whoever it is, similarly, anyone including me can fall sick. I can get depression as much as anybody else can get depression. What is depression? Depression is a feeling of sadness. It's a feeling of loss of interest. It's a feeling of, you know, when your appetite and sleep goes haywire. Okay, and you start getting negative thoughts. When that happens to you, okay, don't say that, oh, kuch nahi hai, sab theek ho jayega. Instead of that, please reach out to a psychologist, reach out to a psychiatrist, reach out to your family doctor. Okay, there are lots and lots of helplines. Pick up the phone and say, do you think, you know, just as I said, do I have COVID? What you need to say is, do I have depression? Okay. And we also need to understand that depression will not go away if I go for a holiday. Depression will not go away if I start doing yoga and meditation. Of course, yoga and meditation help. But at the same time, I may need to take some medication for it. And today on World Mental Health Day, I'm telling everybody here that just as we may take an anti-malarial pill for malaria, similarly, if we need to take an antidepressant, you know, gone are the days that psychiatrists would give neem ki dawaiyan or they will pick you up and give you shock treatment. Nobody does that any longer. Just as we have depression, similarly, we also can get anxiety disorders. You know, some of us, because we have not treated our anxiety, we can land up with, you know, we start drinking and we feel that, oh, let me have a drink and I'm going to be okay. My anxiety will go down. But instead of that, if we go meet the doctor and doctor says, you have an anxiety disorder, please take a tablet for it. Take the tablet. Ask the doctor if the medicine has any side effects. Will I get addicted to it? Once he has answered your questions, you will know that, you know, it's safe to take medication. Similarly, there are people who can have mood disorders. Now, what happens is, if you have a mood disorder, that means that sometimes you may have depression, sometimes you may have a feeling of the opposite of depression, and that is you may feel extremely elated, you may start distributing things, you know, you may feel too generous. That is what is, in simple words, a bipolar disorder. I know a lot of you have heard about bipolar disorders, but that is what a bipolar disorder is. Of course, there are some serious mental health conditions like, say, for example, thought disorders. What is a thought disorder? A thought disorder is that when people get out of touch with reality, you know, they become delusional. They may actually have a lot of fear and they think that there are people who are following them, people who are, doing things to them. And these conditions, and sometimes even when they're alone, they may start listening, hearing voices. Okay, now just as we heard about in depression, you need to take medicines for your mood disorder. Similarly, in thought disorder, you need to take medicines for that. You know, and there are fantastic medicines today. There are medicines that can be given once a week, once a month. You know, so even people who don't like to take medicines, the minute you go to a doctor and they assure you that you're going to be okay, you know, please help such people around you. Okay, because sometimes when the person who is going through this does not understand that he or she is going through a medical health condition, and they may think ki mujhe koi kuch kar raha hai, mujhe koi jadoo kar raha hai, and they instead of that keep going to faith healers, you know, and they feel that somebody will remove my jadoo, someone else is responsible for it. So if you know someone around you who is going through any of these conditions, I would urge you to reach out to them. and tell them that, you know, I'm worried about you because I'm looking at you. You know, you're so smart, you're so intelligent, but you're not able to do what you know what you can do. Are you getting too worried? Are you stressing out too much? Is there something that's bothering you? Please don't gossip about such people. Please don't judge them. Don't say, "Arey, ye apne aap ko bahut hoshyar samajhta tha." See what has happened to him. He or she is going through a health condition. You know, now I think it's already time for question and answers. So I think Sanchali, you know, I think let's just understand what are the concerns that people may have, because I can keep talking about mental health because it is so dear to me.
No, firstly, ma'am, thank you very much, because whatever you have told us, you have enlightened us with. There's a lot of knowledge here. And I think very simple things, if we really follow, it can make a drastic difference or bring a drastic difference in our lives. So thank you very much for that. Yes, there are heaps of questions which are there, which have been shared with me. And I would like to start with some of the common, I think some of the questions which has been asked by a few people. Is there any particular, okay, so meditation is something, as you said, there are a lot of things which are there. One is yoga. The other thing is meditation has certainly become very big. Is there any particular meditation technique which you would recommend?
So, you know, this is a lovely question. Thanks for this question. Because you know what people feel is that once I go and I start meditating, everything is going to be all right. Okay. Now, just as every human being is different, everybody's meditation is actually different. Okay. To me, music is meditation. Okay. So when I'm getting stressed, I just start, I do a music class. Now that helps me to concentrate on something and I feel so good at the end of the music class. You know, so similarly, there are some people who love to dance. For them, dance is meditation. Okay, so anything which makes you connect with yourself is the best meditation for you. Of course, these days you've got a lot of apps on your phone, you know, which you can download and you can meditate. Now, what the whole thing, the theory of meditation is that it just helps you to calm down and focus on what is happening at that very moment, which is also called mindfulness, which, you know, I mean, of course, we do full workshops on mindfulness and teach people to be mindful. Okay. So whatever meditation that works for you is meditation. But again, if you're suffering from depression, sirf meditation karne se, you're not going to be all right. You may need medication plus meditation, you know, and to answer your question.
Thank you, ma'am. So as you said, you know, just find the path which suits you best. And that will be the way to calm your mind. And then you see where you stand. Another question which is coming. This is a question from Nidhi. How do we prevent the ongoing mental health crisis due to COVID-19? You have already mentioned that. Are there any, once again, mindfulness techniques you would suggest to combat this mental health crisis? So there are certain things which you suggested. Would you like to add to this?
Sure. So what is happening in COVID today is that people are actually concerned about a lot of things. Okay. So the first thing is a lot of people have spent 6 months in fear ki mujhe COVID ho jayega, to kya hoga? Okay. At such a point, I would also share with all of you that I have also gone through COVID. Okay. Now, the thing is that we have to take all our precautions. Now, once we have taken our precautions, even if you get COVID, the second thing is that you have to do the right things. Okay. That means contact the doctor, do the test. Please do not stay in denial. No municipality is going to pick you up and throw you away somewhere. The problem is that people get complications because they go into denial and they say, no, it's just a fever. It's just a sore throat. I always get this at this time of the year. Allergy hogi. Okay. And they keep on, they worry that they have COVID, but they don't go and test. Okay. Right. Now, I think our government has done a brilliant job because looking at our population and the way they are taking care of our health, the way they are, you know, calling up every day and finding out there are home isolation, everything. So what we need to do is instead of worrying excessively and behaving as if nothing is, you know, on is, you have to do the right things. Okay. But what has also happened is that one is, of course, you know, as you mentioned earlier, there are people who've lost their loved ones. Okay. And the worst thing is that you don't even get a chance to say bye, you know, and healthcare workers have also been suffering, you know, because the amount of healthcare workers who have got COVID, who have lost their lives, and they have been working round the clock since March, you know. So to them, I would say, or to people who are really on the front line, I would say that you have to take care of your emotional health as well. You know, you do not have to. You are also a human being. You can also break down, you know, and you have to take some time off, you know. So it's important that, yes, we do the right things and then we leave it. But we also talk about what is happening to us. I think that is very, very important. Talk to your friends, talk to your relatives and tell them what you're feeling. This is not the time to feel shy or to be shameful, you know.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for answering that. I am reading questions simultaneously, which are coming live on Insta as well as Facebook. So this is a question which is on Insta from Surbhi. She says, how do you handle people who just don't care about how much you love them? They just use you and talk to you when they are happy or they are in the mood to.
So Surbhi, they are teaching you that, you know, they love themselves more than they love anyone else. Now you need to pick up a lesson from their book and start loving yourself too. You know, I think our whole country, our prime minister is talking about becoming Atmanirbhar. So you need to become Atmanirbhar emotionally. Stop worrying about, see, you always have a choice to either talk to them or to not talk to them. So maybe this is the time you need to put yourself before you put them. Sometimes there are people who are very empathetic and they go out of their way, they help everybody. And then they realize that their friends do not care for them as much as they care for their friends, you know. But if it is hurting you, then it's time to step back and ask yourself, do I really need this relationship in my life? You know, what is this relationship giving me? Don't expect that person to change because that person may never change. But you have a choice. You have a choice to go back. You have a choice to keep, you know, sometimes we become dependent on these people. You know, and we wait for that one phone call or that one good morning that this person may send you and you feel, oh, I feel so happy that someone cares for me. You can care for yourself. And when you let this person go, you will be surprised how soon you will meet people who also care for you. You're allowing this person to be a part of your life and occupying that space, you know. So maybe it's time to give that, to leave that space empty. Don't be scared. मैं अकेले हो जाऊंगी. पीपल इतना डरते हैं अकेलेपन से, यू नो दैट व्हाट विल हैपन इफ आई एम अलोन. नथिंग विल हैपन. यू कैन गिव योरसेल्फ द सेम लव, द सेम केयर, द सेम अटेंशन. एंड वंस यू स्टार्ट डूइंग दैट, यू विल सी हाउ इट बिकम्स अ हैबिट फॉर योरसेल्फ.
In fact, ma'am, I was reading from whatever you're saying, it stems from that. There was a podcast which was I was listening to. We are so busy chasing people who are not into us or who don't like us that we forget to look at those people who actually do care about us. I think we need
absolutely
that concentration.
And start caring for yourself. Now, why do you need anyone else to care for yourself?
Very true. Thank you, ma'am. Another question is, okay, so this is again a general question which we have touched upon. Shivani is asking, can you suggest something about how to manage work stress? So would you like to add on to this or?
Yeah, so you know what happens is we get stressed with work either because we don't have enough work or sometimes we have too much work. Okay, but the time we start, and what happens is I've seen in the last few days is that people get, there's a lot of procrastination. Itna kaam hai. We are not doing that work. We are wasting our time with social media. We are wasting our time getting information that is not useful for us. Okay, so the first thing is disciplining yourself. Okay, so sit down in a place. Even if you have a small house, even if you have, there are children who've been calling me up and saying, you know, we are six people in a house. Now, these kids have reversed their sleep timing so that they work at night when everybody else is sleeping and everyone else is not using internet. So same way, find yourself a workplace and at that time, make your work the most important thing for you. Pay full attention. Stress kab badhta hai when you're not paying full attention. You know, imagine if I'm talking to you and I'm doing two, three other things. Obviously, I'm going to get stressed because I'm not doing anything properly. I'm multitasking. Stop multitasking. Just do one thing at a time. Okay, and do your best. Now, after you've done your best, maybe your best is not enough for your company. or for whoever you're doing it. Okay, but you can't do more than that.
Correct.
And then you have to switch off. If you're finding it difficult to switch off, then maybe this is the time to reach out to those fantastic helplines which are there and talk to a counselor one-on-one, talk to a psychologist. They will teach you skills which will help you to take care of yourself, to become a better version of yourself.
Thank you, ma'am. Another question which is coming now from Anurag. He says, how do I protect my mental health when... there are a couple of questions, actually. I would like to combine them all. It's all about working from home, which is everyone's feeling a lot of stress around that.
Right.
Probably after this period has passed, it's now, you know, it is becoming stressful to just be at home. So can you help with some tips to reduce stress when working from home, to deal with it, basically, and to stay motivated and be protected in terms of our well-being?
Right. So I think I'm going to repeat a few things which I said earlier is that your sleep schedule, your sleep wake-up schedule should be healthy. Okay. So there are some people who are not able to sleep. They take sleeping pills, then they take coffee to wake up. Let's stop having stimulants to wake up and something, you know, to sleep. Some people have also started drinking a lot in these days because they feel neend nahi aa rahi hai, to chalo, let me have some alcohol. Okay. So that is the first thing. The second thing is when you wake up in the morning, okay, try and understand what is stressing you out. Go down to that point which is stressing you out. Are you getting stressed out because you don't have place to work at home? Are you getting stressed out because you don't have money? Are you getting stressed out because your boss is not recognizing your efforts? Are you getting stressed out because you have to pay salary to your employees and you don't have money? You know, people have different points of stress. Now, when you reach that point of stress, see what you can do about it. If you don't have answers, look around you and get people to help you to get answers. The next thing is that, yes, make exercise a part of your routine. And in exercise, I'm not saying do pranayam or do jogging or pick up weights, whatever works for you. Okay. And the next very, very, very important thing is if you feel you're not able to deal with the stress, just reach out for help. There is no shame in taking help.
Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, there's a question which is coming and I'm very intriguing because there's been a lot of talk about this lately. So there is a question which says adolescents or young people are facing self-esteem issues due to social media and peer pressure. How do you think one can positively cope with this?
So I'll tell you, this is a very common thing, you know, even, and it is not only today. I remember, even if you think when you were a teenager, you know, you will feel someone who has curly hair wants straight hair. Someone who has straight hair wants curly hair. So one is they have a lot of body image disturbance. Okay. And that has become worse with social media because people don't put up bad hair day pictures on social media. You know, people know exactly which angle to look, where you look thin, which pout to make. And that's when you look good. You know, now what happens is, for parents who are living with adolescents, and if you recognize that your adolescent is getting very stressed about what is happening on social media, please become your child's friend. Okay, don't give him lectures. Don't tell him, ban karo ye TV, ban karo ye sab. Don't snatch away the phone from them. Instead of that, try and understand what is bothering them. You know, and if your child comes up to you and say, oh, mom, I've got pimples, don't say, ye to sabko hote hain. You know, understand why the pimples are bothering them. Magar uski skin kitni achhi hai, you know. Now, what happens is when we connect with our children and we help them understand, you know, that these are part of growing up issues, okay? But still, I know a lot of parents will tell me, but our children don't listen to us, okay? They only listen to their friends. Now, if you are one of those people who has that problem, that means you haven't listened enough to your child. When you listen to your children's nonsense, they land up listening to your sense. It's a very simple statement. Okay? And it's never too late. Start today. Okay? Don't give them gyan. Don't give them bhashan. In fact, just sit around them. You know, I also have parents who say, oh, we sit around our children. They say, go away from here. Yeah. You know, they don't want to spend time with us. Make a few family routines. You know, this is the time families have bonded. Make routines, start playing games. Don't worry, even if one person is not joining. When three people are having fun, the fourth person will automatically get curious about what you're having fun and will join you. Now, this is the time that the family can bond, the family can connect, and this is the time for you to point out those small, small things, qualities in your child, which make your child special. Okay, so if your child is not a good swimmer, please don't tell him, "Arey, tumhare jaisa swimmer to maine dekha nahi hai." But if he or she is a kind person, you can say that, you know, you're so kind, you know, that day I saw what you did for someone, you know, and that's a very special skill to have. Now, many a times what happens is parents in their own anxiety of correcting their children or feeling, "Arey, there's so much competition, mera bachcha kya karega?" Okay, they only point out negative things to their children. Tumne ye nahi kiya, tumne wo nahi kiya. We forget to point out positive things. And when you start slowly, slowly pointing out positive things in your child, forget what the world is doing to them. You are going to make a difference in your child's life, and your child will understand ki, okay, these are passing phases. But if you feel ki problem bahut badh gaya hai, then maybe it's the time to reach out to a psychologist and to discuss one-on-one what is the problem. Sometimes adolescents face a lot of body image issues, face a lot of issues because they are going through depression. Jaise maine depression ki baat ki, anybody can go through it. Elderly people can go through it. Children can go through it. And just as when you're going through COVID, you take medicine, same way when you're going through depression or self-esteem issues, which may be a beginning of depression, you reach out, you take the medicine, and you're going to be fine.
Thank you, ma'am. I think everything has a cure. You just need to find where that cure is and what works for you, as you have been guiding us. Another pertinent question, which is coming from Pratik, and the person talks about financial stress. He said, could you suggest ways to combat financial stress people are going through right now? What do you think basically will help to sort this thing in mind or to help us?
Right. So, you know, I think Pratik, everybody, I think the poorest man and the richest man is going through financial stress today. Okay, because things have changed. Now, when things change, okay, who needs to change? You need to change. Okay, so what do you need to do? You need to rework, you need to rebalance. Okay, now this year is not about saving money. This year is about, you know, keeping your head above the water and, you know, just wading through it till it gets over. I know a lot of people are finding it difficult to make two ends meet. So at such a time is first assess what your real needs are, you know, and what are the extra needs. I know you may have had dreams about buying that house this year or finishing off paying your EMIs or whatever it is. So whatever stress you're having, okay, first break it up and see, can I spend less? That is the first thing that I'm telling everybody. If Pratik is a married man and he's staying with his kids, please have this discussion with your children in a very relaxed manner. Okay. I remember, you know, when we were growing up and there were times when my parents were going through financial stress, my father would tell us, you know, a very simple thing. He would say, you know, beta, emergency hai. We all knew what emergency meant. Emergency meant that, yes, there is a little financial stress, but we did not stop enjoying. We would go to the beach and we would play. It did not cost us money there to do that. We would play games in the house. But yes, we would all save our little pocket money. And I remember going with piggy bank to my father and saying, listen, if you can use this money, please use it. You know, so what I'm saying is, so just because he was very relaxed while he was doing it. So it's important to be relaxed, because if you're anxious, you can't think. It just, your thoughts just cloud your mind. But if you're relaxed, kuch na kuch solution nikal aata hai. And that is how we need to deal with the stress at that time. And yes, again, I repeat, share the burden. Speak to your spouse, speak to your parents, speak to your friends. If you owe someone money, speak to that person. Don't stay away from that person. Tell them that, you know, this is what I'm going through. And yes, if you're really feeling terrible about it, please reach out for help. You know, because every problem has a solution.
Thank you. I hope, Pratik, that answers your question. And now coming to a question, ma'am, which is, okay, so there has been, mental health has gained so much attention in the last few years. And I think with everything happening, they are saying that many people don't really know the meaning of it, which we have elaborated, you have elaborated on. But it has become more of a trend, you know. So how would you define mental health to people who just think that, hey, it's a trend, follow it, or just to say that, you know, how people loosely use the word depression? Sometimes there's one segment which says that they don't know what it is. And some people say, oh, the simple solution is I'm depressed, because probably it goes well with the media. So how do you address for that?
So what happens is, of course, this word has been used very fashionably or very loosely. You know, so even if you're stressed about something, even if you're disappointed about something, you say, oh, I'm depressed, you know. Yeah. And a lot of people then also have a lot of solutions, you know, for depression. Do this and your depression will go away. Now, depression is a health condition. Okay, yes, we can prevent stress. I mean, or we can deal with stress and prevent distress. But just as I keep loving this example of equating it with COVID. We can wear a mask, we can keep ourselves protected. But jisko hota hai, that person needs to do what they need to do, you know. So I can't be fashionable and say, oh, I got COVID, you know. So it is, I mean, either I got it or I didn't get it, you know. So similarly, this is something, it is a medical disorder. It is not going to go away if you go for a holiday or if you listen to music or no, don't get stressed. It is not something like that. Okay, you need medical help. The faster you take it, the better it is. And there is no shame about taking it, because if you don't take it, the complication of depression is that people may go towards suicide. Okay, and this is something which is very, very important. Unfortunately, you know, we have a lot of suicides. Last year's statistics tell us that about 1,40,000 people who killed themselves, okay, who died of suicide. And a lot of these were preventable deaths because they are in a young population, you know. And it was just because at that particular time, they did not get the help. They were preventable. Okay, so if somebody talks about wanting to harm themselves, you know, or about, I don't think life is worth living, people around them need to take this very, very seriously. And just like you would react if I'm sitting next to you and I got a heart attack, what would you do? You would just take me to the doctor, right? That's exactly what I need you to do. If someone is, don't think ye to mazak karta rehta hai, ye to hamesha bolta rehta hai. You know, even if that person is doing mazak, this is not the way to do mazak. Okay, so that person needs help. So, you know, I would want all the viewers to take this very, very seriously.
Thank you very much, ma'am. I think if I keep talking about this topic, there is going to be no end to it. But thank you for giving in this much time, literally an hour into the conversation, and giving us a lot of insights, a lot of tips, which I think will really help us. Thank you for being a part of this special, special episode right here with ICICI Lombard, Wellness 360 from home. And thank you for being here. Well, and everyone who's watching us live, thank you for being a part of this session. I hope there's a lot of takeaway that you have from here. Well, what we see is what mental health needs is more, I would say, sunlight, more candor, and more unshamed conversations. And of course, anything that's human, a very famous quote, anything that's human is mentionable, and anything that is mentionable can be more manageable. When we can talk about our feelings, they become less overwhelming, less upsetting, and of course, less scary. So keep talking. Keep being well, stay healthy, and have a great World Mental Health Day. Start investing in your mental health right now. This is your MC, Sanchali Arora, signing off. Thank you all for being here. Thank you on behalf of ICICI Lombard.